I think first and foremost, of course, is the sequence itself. And it's actually stood up to the test of time pretty well. It's going to be replaced with an updated version where all the repeats and the centromeres are filled in. But, you know, it's been almost not quite 20 years, but it's been basically the reference that everybody has used. And it's just catalyzed research in human genetics and human health and behavior. I mean, it's more than we could have hoped for. So that's one. Second, I think, is the open data policy and the issuing of patents. That's also been an important legacy. That's been adopted by other community-based projects and even by other fields. It's been held up as an example. And of course, it's clear that it's by having it open, it's just made a huge difference. There are no restrictions. Everybody can have it and do whatever they want. You don't have to have a big lab. You don't have to be rich. It's just had a huge catalytic effect. And I guess I'd say the third one is that the success of the Human Genome Project opened everybody's eyes to the power of having genomes. First with the worm and yeast and H. flu, those genomes, but then the human genome, having that whole thing in front of you just changed people's way of doing science. And so you can't do science today, or biology anyway, without thinking about genomes.